Hide not thy face from thy servant, They are confounded and brought into shame and seek to do evil. and her tears are on her cheeks. Among all her lovers she hath none to comfort her. All her friends have dealt treacherously with her. Return unto the Lord thy God. become like hearts that find no pasture. And they are gone without strength before the and of her miseries, all her pleasant things that she had done in the days of old, when her people fell into the hand of the enemy, and none did help her. The adversary saw and did mock at her Sabbaths. Therefore she is removed. All that honored her despise her, because they have seen her nakedness. Yea, she sigheth and turneth in her skirts, she remembereth not her last end. Therefore she came down wonderfully, she had no comforter. O Lord, behold my affliction, for the enemy hath magnified himself. Jerusalem, Jerusalem, for she hath seen that the heathen hath entered into her sanctuary. Whom thou didst command that they should not enter into thy congregation. Is it nothing to you, all ye that pass by? Behold and see. If there be any sorrow like unto my sorrow, which is done unto me, wherewith the Lord hath afflicted me, in the day of his fierce anger, it prevaileth against them. He hath spread a net for my feet, and he hath turned me back. He hath made me desolate and faint all the day long. Jerusalem, Jerusalem,
Presence.
From the treatise of Saint Augustine, the Bishop on the Psalms. Hear my prayer, O God, and hide not thyself from my petition. Take heed unto me and hear me. These are the words of one disquieted. In trouble and anxiety, he prays under much suffering, desiring to be released from evil. Let us now see under what evil he lies. And when he begins to speak, let us place ourselves by him, that, sharing his tribulation, we may also join in his prayer. I mourn, saith he, in my prayer, and am vexed. When does he mourn? When is he vexed? He says, in my prayer. He speaks of the evil men whom he suffers, and that sufferance of evil men he calls his complaint. Think not that the evil are in this world soon over, or that God makes no use of them. Every wicked man lives either that he may be corrected himself, or that the righteous may be exercised by him. Not against men whom we see,
but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world. Lest that by saying the world, ye should think perhaps that devils are rulers of heaven and earth, he says, of the darkness of the world. He says, of the world, that is, the lovers of this world, of the world, that is, the impious and wicked, of the world, that is, of which the gospel saith, and the world knew him not. And strife in the city. See the glory of the cross itself. Now on the brow of kings is placed that cross which enemies did deride. Effect hath proved strength. He hath subdued the world, not with steel, but with wood. The wood of the cross seemed a worthy object of scorn to his enemies. And standing before that wood, they wagged their heads, saying, if thou be the Son of God, come down from the cross. He stretched forth his hands to an unbelieving and gainsaying people. If he is just who lives by faith, he is unrighteous who has not faith. Therefore, when he saith unrighteousness, understand that it is unbelief. The Lord saw unrighteousness and strife in the city, and stretched out his hand to an unbelieving and gainsaying people. And yet, waiting for them, he said, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do.
Thank you.
Fallen, all the And the
considering